Okay, here's a lure that may also be a very excellent choice to cure the summertime blues, and it is called a Hula StickZ. Look at how much crawdads are down in that fish's gullet. It is stuffing itself with crawdads. We had a really good time. Two beautiful bass simultaneously twice in a row.
Back to back.
Okay, folks, as you know, it's summertime, so Lorraine is going to come out and help me identify some lures that should work when the fish are no longer on the banks in this warm water, especially with a lot of sunny days and stuff. They do move off the bank out into a little bit deeper water, and so we're going to use some finesse stuff today and see if we can catch them. Hey, Lorraine, what do you say we get out here on binder and see if anything's biting?
Try to find where the fish are. It's the first time I've been on binder, so I hope we find something.
Me too. You ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Okay, let's go.
Let's do it.
I'm actually very proud of this ZeechieZ mod, because it's so versatile. You can make them large, you can make them longer, you can make them smaller. And most of you know that Elastec is buoyant, so it'll stand up as it's bouncing around on the bottom. The tail will, if you stop it, the tail will come to rest and stand up. And the longer you soak Elastec in the water, the softer and more supple it becomes, which adds to its fish catching attractiveness. ZeechieZ, fun lures. Okay, this bass came off of a lure that I called a ZeechieZ, and the reason it works so well is very evident in the tank. Hey, Lorraine, I found one lure that...
What is it?
Well, you'll see. It is nothing more than a strip of Elastec with another strip of Elastec glued to the bottom, and it winds up looking like a leech. They're all nice when we're having... Okay, here's a pretty nifty little lure called a TRD TicklerZ. And these rascals are fun to use. They're very buoyant. They got all kind of laminate colors. You can mount them all kind of different ways. I've actually got this one on a Bear Paws peen head jig, 1/16 ounce. And this is the green pumpkin orange, I think, color. Just terrific. Looks like a crawdad. And when the fish are not right on the shore, if they're out from the shore a little ways, maybe in 7, 8, 9, 10 feet of water, when it lands on the bottom, it's going to go whoop, just like that. And see those? See that little tail? And the bass come running. TRD TicklerZ. Hey, Lorraine. I'm tickled. Whoa! He's a jumper. Another cure for the summertime blues. And look how well these Bear Paws peen heads work. They are something else. Binder is full of bass.
It is full of bass.
Okay, Lorraine, this is called a Hula StickZ. And this laminate is obviously PB&J.
My favorite.
Yeah. It has a little twinkie tail. Check it out. It has a little tentacle power tail going on there. And in the tank, it is really something. It'll sit up like this and go, hello, come get me. It'll jump and hop around the bottom. And I'm using a 1/16 ounce jig head with the lead collar snipped off. Then it becomes just like a worm. I got super glue, a couple of drops of super glue on the end of this little ball head jig. Works really good. This might be something for the summertime blues. This could be a vaccine.
Yes.
I got to take 2 weeks. I got to have a fine vacation. This is a decent bass for binder right here. Ooh, and he's spitting up crawdads. Look at how much crawdads are down in that fish's gullet. It is stuffing itself with crawdads. So why does a hula stick look like a crawdad? I don't know. And this is a very nice looking bass. Check it out, Lorraine. This fine fat specimen is just a whisker shy. It's 14 and 3/4. That's a really good bass for me at binder. Go back and bite some more stuff. Who says there ain't no cure for the summertime blues? Hey, Lorraine.
Yeah.
Did you find the cure for the summertime blues?
I did. I caught it with a hula stick.
There you go.
The Hulu stick.
Hulu stick. You're hauling them in now, girl.
Yeah.
You have to take 2 weeks. You got to have a fine vacation. Good job. That's a good one.
Yeah.
I think I found another cure. Another tasty morsel. This one grabbed was a Z-Man finesse worm in PB&J. I think they're on a crawdad type pattern. And although it's not orange, they must think these PB&J lures are some kind of crawdad because they're all over them. Yeah, they're nice, fat, and healthy fish, aren't they? All right. I got a fever. You know what can cure it? Okay, look at that sun going down and the fish are coming out. They are just so well fed. Beautiful. All right, see you, buddy. I love it when they just explode right in front of you. Hello. Oh my goodness, Lorraine. Take your, ooh, way to go. Take your time, he's fine. Oh my goodness. I think we definitely had a cure for the summertime blues.
I think we did.
Good job, Lorraine, that's a dandy. All right.
Simultaneously, back to back.
Yep, nice double.
Goodbye, fish.
RTR. Okay, Sparky. No need to go to the Lake of the Ozarks, man. Just come here to Jeff City. Beautiful. Yeah, there's a net. You can just slide right on in there. There you go. Well done. We have caught a lot of fish in the last 15 or 20 minutes. It's just been pow, 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 pow. That's a good fish.
I guess this calls for the net.
That's a nice one. There you go. All right, RTR, pow. So we had two nice fish to conclude this operation. Both of them 14 and a half, 14 and 3/4. And they are some beauties, aren't they, Lorraine?
Yes.
All right, I'll catch you next time. Thank you for the nice fight. Look at that stomach. Look at the tummy on that rascal.
I know, that's strong.
Okay, Lorraine, there's your bass. Isn't that a beauty?
Yes, he is.
All right.
Heavy, heavy.
We had a really good time. Two beautiful bass simultaneously twice in a row.
Back to back. Woo!
All right, good job.
Good job, Don.
All right, let's call her quits. Let's get in before it gets too dark.
All right.
God bless.
Mm-hmm.